Hi friends, let us today understand how to design or how to analyze a polyphase structures. First, let us understand why we need a polyphase structures, or what is the need of polyphase structures in need to be studied in this particular module. The reason for this is, as we have seen, that we are designing interpolators and decimators. In that interpolators and decimators, we require filters which are low pass filters. So if we use a direct form filter, there is no problem in that. We can use it. There is no restriction that you cannot use a direct form filters. But the direct form filters produces a huge level of complexity in computation, as well as the time required to compute the factors is also large. We know that the efficiency of the direct form filters depends on its multiplication and the adders. And if we use the canonic structure, then the degree of the polynomial actually decides the number of additions and or number of delay blocks in the system. As the number of the delay block increases, the addition and the multiplication process also increases. Okay, as well as this structures becomes less efficient at multi-rate signal processing. So the multi-rate signal processing has really boosted up and advanced, okay, because of the origin of polyphase structures. So because of this, we are studying polyphase structures, and because their efficiency is higher as compared to direct form, we'll be implementing the filters in the multi-rate signal processing using polyphase structures. So first, let us understand how to analyze a filter structure using polyphase. So we will analyze today a polyphase filter structure. So in a polyphase filter structure, let us consider an FIR first. Easier concept first. So let us start with an FIR structure. So I consider a transfer function h of z to be equal to, let's say, n going from minus infinity to plus infinity. You can consider 0 to infinity, that's not a problem. H of n z raised to minus n. So this is a transfer function of a given filter, where n goes from minus infinity to plus infinity, h of n z raised to minus n. Okay, what I do is I decompose this transfer function, and I divide the sequence into even and odd parts. So let us divide it. So my h of z will be equal to summation going from n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, h of 2n z raised to minus n plus summation n going from minus infinity, sorry, this will be 2n to infinity, h of 2n plus 1 z raised to minus 2n minus 1. Okay, so what I did, I decomposed into even coefficients of h of n and odd coefficient of h of n. So this is my even coefficients, and this is my odd coefficients. Okay, that is, I have decomposed into two sets, one is even and one is odd. What I do is, next we will just do some mathematical calculations. H of z is equal to summation going from n of minus infinity to plus infinity, h of 2n z raised to minus 2n plus summation going from minus infinity to plus infinity, h of 2n plus 1. And over here I have z raised to minus 2n into, I can write z raised to minus 1, which is independent on n. So I will bring it out. So this z of n 1, I will bring it out of summation and keep it over here. So then it becomes summation n going from minus infinity to plus infinity, h of 2n z raised to minus 2n plus summation n going from minus infinity to plus infinity. Oh, I'm extremely sorry. Okay, fine, no problem. H of 2n, z raised to minus 2n, and we have left with 1, z raised to minus 1, which I'll write here as z raised to minus 1. Okay, then we will do further adjustment. So the further adjustment will be like this: summation n going from minus infinity to plus infinity, h of 2n, z raised to 2, the whole raised to minus n, plus z inverse, summation n going from minus infinity to plus infinity, h of 2n plus 1, z raised to 2, the whole raised to minus n. Again, this is a z transform of h of 2n, but what should be the coefficient? Z square. And this will be also a z transform of h of 2n plus 1, but what should be the coefficient? Z square. So I put this value, I write this value as, let's say, e o e 0 of z square, and this I write as e 1 of z square, this factor. Okay, so I have two factors. I have written one as e 0 of z square, and second one I have written as e 1 of z square. Therefore my h of z will now look like h of z to be equal to e 0 of z plus z inverse e 1 of, oh sorry, e z square. Okay, so this is my h of z. So what I did, I now decomposed my complete one big transfer function or one big filter into two smaller filters. One is e 0 and one is e 1. Why I got e 0 and e 1? Because I have decomposed into two sets. Okay, let us just see an example. The example for this I take for an FIR, let's say, easy one first. For an FIR, I consider my transfer function h of z to be 1 plus 2z inverse plus 3z raised to minus 2 plus 4z raised to minus 3. Okay, now I have to decompose. So the simpler is, this is my h of 0, this is my h of 1, this is h of 2, and this is h of 3. So what we will do, we will decompose into 2. So this becomes my even samples and this becomes my odd samples. Okay, so I will get h of 2n will be equal to 1 comma 3, and h of 2n plus 1, which is odd samples, which is 2 comma 4. Okay, therefore e 0 of z, I'm calculating, I'm not calculating z square, e 0 of z will be 1 plus 3 z raised to minus 1. Okay, when you will calculate z raised to 2, so instead of putting z, you will put z square, so it will be 1, because there is no z over here, plus 3 z square. Okay, you'll just replace z by z square, and e 1 of z will be equal to, here it will be 2 plus 4 z raised to minus 1. Okay, that is nothing but the e 1 of z and e 2 of z. So we have decomposed it into two separate sets. Okay, so now I will design for e 0 of z and e 1 of z, and then we will combine them in this form to give me the final h of z. So that is the polyphase structure. So that was an FIR polyphase structure. Let us go for an example with IIR polyphase structure. For an IIR polyphase structure, I will take the transfer function as h of z to be equal to, let's say, 1 upon 1 minus alpha z inverse. It's an all pole filter. Okay, then we can decompose this as 1 upon 1 minus alpha square z raised to minus 2 plus alpha z inverse, okay, upon 1 minus alpha square z raised to minus 2. Okay, so what will be E naught of Z will be equal to 1 over 1 minus alpha square Z raised to minus 1, and E1 of Z will be equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha square Z raised to minus 1. Okay, so this is E1. I'm removing Z inverse from here because that will take care as this will be H of Z, and I can say that this is my E0 of Z square plus Z inverse of E1 of Z square. So this is one and the same. So I'm just writing E0 of Z and E1 of Z instead of E0 of Z square and E1 of Z square. Okay. So now let us take this idea to a general case. So in general, if suppose I'm not dividing the sequence into even an odd part, rather I'm dividing it into m equal subparts, then n equal subparts, then I need to check that what will be my general scenario. So if I divide it into or decompose into m parts, and where m is an integer, then I will have h of z. The first value of h of z, I will write first the 2 point so that you will get an idea. I'll write it over here. H of z is equal to the first part was e naught of z, okay, then it was a z square plus z inverse e naught of z raised square. Okay, your m factor was equal to 2 because I have decomposed it into 2 subparts. Okay, so now I am decomposing into m subparts. So h of z will be equal to e naught, okay, of z raised to m plus z raised to minus 1 E1 of z raised to m plus z raised to minus 2 E2 of z raised to m, and so on and so forth. What will be the last factor? Last factor will be equal to z raised to minus m minus 1 em minus 1 z raised to m. Because here when it was 2, I went till E1. So here also I will go to M minus 1. Okay. So the summation, if I write in terms of summation, then H of Z will be equal to, okay, if I write in terms of summation, then H of Z will be equal to summation L going from 0 to M minus 1. Okay. Z raised to minus L. Okay, E L of Z raised to M. Correct? So this is what the factor will be. And what will be E L of Z? E L of Z, which is this, E L of Z will be equal to summation for M or N, we can say minus infinity to plus infinity, E of n z raised to minus n. Okay, and E of n will be nothing but the transposition or H of ml. Okay, so this type of decomposition, polyphase decomposition, is called as type 1 type of a decomposition. So when I represent this form of representation, it is called as a type 1 type of a polyphase decomposition. We also have type 2 type of a polyphase decomposition, which is just rearrangement of the terms. So I'll directly write this as to be type 2 polyphase decomposition is given as H of Z, which is equal to summation L going from 0 to M minus 1 Z raised to minus M minus 1 minus L into E, we called it as, let's say, R L of Z raised to M and where R L of Z raised to M is written as E of M minus 1 minus L of Z. Okay, and this is type 2 kind of a polyphase decomposition. So we have type 1 polyphase decomposition and we have type 2 polyphase decomposition. So this is what in general a polyphase decomposition is all about. Thank you.